The word of the Lord came to Jonah, son of Amittai, saying, "Get up and go to the great city of Nineveh. Announce my judgment against it, for I have seen how wicked its people are." But Jonah got up and went in the opposite direction in order to get away from the Lord. He went down to the seacoast to the port of Joppa, where he found a ship that was sailing for Tarshish. He bought a ticket and he went on board, hoping that by going away to the west, he could escape from the Lord's presence. But while the ship was sailing along, suddenly the Lord flung a powerful wind over the sea, causing a violent storm that threatened to break the ship apart. Fearing for their lives, the desperate sailors shouted to their gods for help and threw the cargo overboard to lighten the ship. And all this time, Jonah was sound asleep down in the hold. So the captain went down after him. "How can you sleep at a time like this?" he said. "Get up and pray to your God. Maybe he will have mercy on us and spare our lives." Then the ship's crew cast lots to see which of them had offended the gods and caused the storm. And when they did this, Jonah lost the toss. "What have you done to bring this awful storm down on us?" they demanded. "Who are you? What do you do? What is your country? Who are your people?" And Jonah replied, "I am a Hebrew. I worship the Lord God of heaven, who made the sea and dry land." Then he told them he was running away from the Lord. When the sailors heard this, they were terrified. "Oh, why did you do it?" they groaned. And then, because the storm was getting worse all the time, they asked Jonah, "What should we do to you to stop the storm?" "Pick me up and throw me into the sea," he said, "and it will become calm again, for I know that this terrible storm is all my fault." Instead, the sailors tried even harder to row the ship safely to the shore, but the stormy seas were too violent for them, and they couldn't make it. Then the sailors prayed to the Lord, Jonah's God. "Oh Lord," they pleaded, "don't make us die for this man's sin. And don't hold us responsible for his death, Lord, because it's not our fault. You have sent this storm down on him for your own good reasons." Then they picked Jonah up and they threw him into the raging sea. And at once the storm stopped. The sailors were awestruck by the Lord's mighty power. And they offered him a sacrifice and vowed to serve him. Now the Lord had arranged for a great fish to swallow Jonah. And Jonah was inside the belly of the fish for 3 days and 3 nights. Then Jonah prayed to the Lord his God from inside the fish. He said, "I cried out to the Lord in my great trouble, and he answered me. I called to you from Sheol, the world of the dead, and Lord, you heard me. You threw me into the ocean depths, and I sank down to the heart of the sea. I was buried beneath your wild and stormy waves. Then I said, 'Lord, you have driven me from your presence. How will I ever again see your holy temple?' I sank beneath the waves and death was very near. The waters closed in around me. Seaweed wrapped itself around my head. I sank to the very roots of the mountains. I was locked out of life and imprisoned in the world of the dead. But you, O Lord, my God, have rescued me from the yawning jaws of death. When I had lost all hope, I turned my thoughts once more to the Lord, and my earnest prayer went out to you in your holy temple. Those who worship false gods turn their backs on all of God's mercies. But I will offer sacrifices to you with songs of praise, and I will fulfill all of my vows, for my salvation comes from the Lord alone. Then the Lord ordered the fish to spit up Jonah on the beach. And it did. Now the word of the Lord came to Jonah a second time, saying, "Get up, go to the great city of Nineveh, and deliver the message of judgment I have given you." This time Jonah obeyed the Lord's command, and he went to Nineveh, a city so large it took 3 days just to walk across it. On the first day that Jonah entered the city, he began shouting to the people, 40 days from now, Nineveh will be destroyed." The people of Nineveh believed God's message. And from the greatest to the least, they decided to go without food and to wear sackcloth to show their sorrow. When the king of Nineveh heard what Jonah was saying, he stepped down from his throne. He took off his royal robe. He dressed himself in sackcloth, and he sat on a heap of ashes. Then the king sent this decree throughout the city: no one, not even the animals, may eat or drink anything at all. Everyone is required to wear sackcloth and pray earnestly to God. Everyone must stop their evil ways and stop all their violence. Who can tell? Perhaps even now, God will have pity on us and hold back his fierce anger from destroying us. When God saw that they had stopped their evil ways, he had mercy on them, and he did not carry out the destruction he had threatened. Now, this change of plans upset Jonah, and he became very angry. So he complained to the Lord about it. "Didn't I say before I left home that you would do this, Lord? That's why I ran away to Tarshish. I knew that you were a gracious and compassionate God, slow to get angry, full of unfailing love. I knew how easily you could cancel your plans for destroying these people. Just kill me now, Lord. I'd rather be dead than alive, because nothing I predicted is going to happen." And the Lord said to Jonah, "Is it right for you to be angry about this?" Jonah went out to the east side of the city, where he built a shelter to sit while he waited to see if anything at all would happen to the city of Nineveh. And the Lord God arranged for a leafy plant to grow there. And soon it spread its broad leaves over Jonah's head, shading him from the sun. This gave Jonah some relief from his discomfort. And Jonah was very grateful for the plant. In fact, Jonah rejoiced with great joy over that plant. But the Lord also prepared a worm. And the next morning at dawn, the worm ate through the stem of that plant so that it died and withered away. And as the sun grew hot, the Lord sent a scorching east wind to blow on Jonah. And the sun beat down on his head so that he grew faint, and wish to die, death would certainly be better than this, he declared. And the Lord said to Jonah, you feel sorry about the plant for which you did not work and which you did not cause to grow, which sprang up overnight and perished overnight. Should I not have compassion on Nineveh, a city of over 120,000 people who don't know their right hand from their left hand, people living in spiritual darkness, not to mention all the animals? Should I not have compassion on them? Let's pray. Heavenly Father, you have blessed us with so many leafy plants. Things for which we did not work, things that we did not cause to grow, and yet we are blessed. But Lord, may I never get so bound up in the things with which I have been blessed that I fail to rejoice when you show mercy to someone that I don't like. Lord, would you give us your heart of compassion? Would you give us your love for those people for whom Christ died? In Jesus' name, amen.